Hey everyone, in this video I want to go over how to create a data visualization known as a population pyramid. So in this video I want to go over how you can plot it in R two different ways. I'm going to show you one way, which would look like this, and this graph has a little bit of interactivity to it. So if you hover over one of the bars, it will give you a little text box, and you can also either group or stack the data. And then there's going to be a second way that you can show the data, which looks very similar, and this population pyramid also has some interactivity as well with the hovering. But basically, it's going to be a demo of how you can create a plot that looks like this in R, and I will put the code for everything in the description box below. So actually, the correct term for this data viz is called a butterfly chart. So it kind of looks like two wings of a butterfly, but usually people refer to these, or I feel like they're more well known as being population pyramids, because that's their most common application, is to show the population for a country at a certain year or throughout the years for both male and female populations. The pink bars refer to the population of females grouped by age, and then the blue represents the population of men grouped by age, and this is the most common way you see these butterfly charts. So sometimes these data visualizations are just known as population pyramids. When I first had the idea for making this video, I had never done a population pyramid in R before, and I figured that there would be an R package that you install, and then that would easily create population pyramids. But what I found is actually there's no good package that I really like. I will put a link in the description box below to this URL. So there are some online tutorials of how to make population pyramids, and basically I'm following a modified version of using a package called RChart. But again, as I'll mention later on, I'm using some modifications. There's also code on this URL to use ggplot2 and just create basically a modified version of a bar graph. But there's no good R package that will just easily, you can just pass in a data frame and it will create a population pyramid for you. Let me show you the way I solved the problem of being able to create a graph that looks like this and has some interactivity to it that does not use just the standard ggplot2 bar charts. To create the data visualizations that I showed in the beginning of the video, we're going to have to use two R packages. So one is called reshape2. If you don't have that, you just have to install it first. And then the other one is called RCharts. So you have to run this line of code to install RCharts. So you have to get it from GitHub and you have to use DevTools. So if you don't have DevTools, you have to install DevTools first, load it in, and then use install GitHub to get the code from a GitHub repository. And that will give you then the ability to load in the RCharts package. And again, you need reshape2 as well. And then we're also going to need some code for creating the function that creates the population pyramids. So I showed you two styles. So this style of population pyramid is from a function called hPyramid. And then the second function is called npyramid. And so this refers to the different JavaScript code that is used to create the interactivity in the data visualizations. So the npyramid uses NVD3, and the hPyramid uses HighCharts JavaScript. So again, I will put this code in the description box below, but you just basically want to run this file to have these two functions loaded in. So these are functions that I got from this website, or I found it online. I will put a link to the original code in the description box, but this code is out of date. And so if you just try to run this tutorial in the second part, it actually doesn't work and it pulls data from a website that doesn't exist anymore, and it's specific to one database anyway. And it would be better just to have the code be able to run for any data frame. So I slightly modified the code. I removed basically a couple things and I added a couple lines to make it be able to take in a data frame. Then in the next line of code, you just want to load in your data. So I'm loading in a data set from the Census Bureau, and I got it from this table on data.census.gov. So this is table S0101, which is age and sex. And I got age and sex population data for the United States for the year 2021. So basically, I want to be able to create a population pyramid for a sample of the population, or an estimate of the population of the United States from the Census Bureau for 2021. And so this is the data set here. And I just selected the cells, right click, and then copied. And I copied copied that over to a text file, and the text file is what I'm reading in. So it's the text file 2021data.txt. I'll click it to show you what it looks like. So I just have the population for the different age categories, and then I have the population for male, and I have the population for female in separate columns. So to run the pyramid lines of code, your dataset has to have headers that say age, male, and female. You can modify the code that I'm going to share to have it be something else if you don't want to do a population pyramid of male and female. Maybe you have other data. For example, you can do a butterfly chart of revenue, for example, and then it would be different from this setup. But this is the setup that we use to make an actual population pyramid, so I'm just going to leave that as it is, but you can go into the code and easily change the labels. But again, for the way I have the code written right now, the data visualization is going to show male and female values for an age variable. So it's going to look for those header columns in your data frame. Then when we want to actually create the population pyramid, it's going to be very easy because we just have to run one line of code. So for the first design that I showed, it's going to be the code hPyramid. Then we're going to pass in the name of the data frame. And again, the data frame has to have male, female, and age columns. We're going to pass in the year the data refers to. So this is data from 2021. And then you're going to pass in the colors that you want the bar charts to look like. So I'm just going to run this line of code. And then that will give me the design that uses HiCharts JavaScript, which is this one. So that creates this data visualization. And then for the second style of population pyramid, it's just going to be the same thing. You're going to use a function called nPyramid this time, but again, you're going to pass in the data frame, the year, and the colors that you want for the bars. And then if you run this line of code, you're going to get this second style of data visualization. And that's it for this video, and thank you guys for watching.